separate friends. In this question we are given a container is divided into two equal parts 1 and 2 by a partition with a small hole of diameter d. Okay, the two partitions, they are filled with same ideal gas but held at temperatures T1 and T2 by connecting two heat reservoirs. Fine, there are different temperatures of the two sections. If lambda 1 and lambda 2 be the mean free paths of the gas particles in the two parts such that the diameter is very very large as compared to the mean free path, then lambda 1 by lambda 2 is close to, okay. So this is this question is based on mean free path. Mean free path is actually given by the expression 1 over root 2 pi r square into nv, where nv is the number density of particles, that is the total number of particles divided by total volume. Now we know from the ideal gas equation PV equals nRT, where n here represents the number of moles, which can be rewritten as total number of particles divided by Avogadro number into r into t. This can be rearranged and written as total number of particles r by na can be written as Boltzmann constant multiplied by temperature T. Now from here we could rearrange and write down capital N by V is equal to this capital N divided by this V. This is equal to P divided by Boltzmann constant into temperature. So this is actually NV, the number density of particles. Now if we fill this expression here, we get the mean free path as equal to 1 over root 2 pi r square into P divided by KBT. So KBT will go into the numerator. So this is the expression of mean free path dependent on temperature. Now that means lambda 1 by lambda 2, this will be equal to temperature T1 by T2. We are given that the ideal gases are identical, that means their radii is same, KB Boltzmann constant is same, they are kept in the same container, so external pressure should be same, only the temperature ratio would come out here as T1 by T2. So T1 is given to us as 150, T2 is given to us as 300, so we get the ratio as 1 by 2, comes out to be equal to 0.5, which is given to us in option B. So the correct answer that we'll mark here in this question is option B. The mean free path is directly proportional to temperature.